In this video, we're going to talk about skills that you can use to become a remote worker. So you can become a freelancer that works remotely from anywhere of your choosing. So that's what we're going to talk about in this video. If you enjoy this content, make sure to like this video and subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications so you do not miss any future videos. So let's jump into this and discuss the topic of what skills you need to become a remote freelancer. One of the best things about being able to work remotely and being able to work as a freelancer is that it frees you up to be able to do things in life that you would normally not be able to do if you're working a regular 9-to-5 job. And this is something I've been doing personally over the past 7 or 8 years now. I've lived overseas since about 2013, and I've moved around a little bit and worked various jobs. I've mostly worked entirely by myself online, but there are several times during that period I've dipped in and out of either part-time work or a full-time job, but ultimately I always end up going back to working for myself because that is the one area that I can control my own life. So working for yourself allows you the freedom to travel to different places, to work from your own house without having to travel into the city or into a shared office space. And it really gives you the opportunity to build work around your life rather than building your life around your work or your job. So there are many, many reasons why you may want to work remotely. And especially in this past couple of years with everything that's been going on in the world, I think now it's actually an easier time to work remotely than ever before. And it really gives you an opportunity to structure life the way you want it on your own terms. So let's jump into some of the skills that you can use to work remotely for yourself as a freelancer. So the first thing we're going to talk about here is any existing skill sets that you may already have. Some of the most popular skill sets that people use when they work remotely are things like web development, graphic design, content writing, or search engine optimization skills. So if you have some of these skills, you should be able to find work quite easily if you brand yourself correctly, if you have a website and a portfolio. So there are skills like that that are really easy to just transition into a remote job. But if you don't have some of these skills, we're going to look at some things that you can do to make yourself employable, to still give you an opportunity to live the life you want and work remotely from anywhere that you desire. One example of a job you can do remotely without having any particular skill set is working as a virtual assistant. So I've hired many different virtual assistants over the years just to make my life easier, to organize things, to do basic editing of content or writing up notes or doing research on particular topics, those kind of tasks that most people can do without any specific training. Another type of work that you can do that doesn't really require any specific skills is translation work. So if you have more than one language, if you can speak multiple languages and you can read and write in multiple languages, there is a very good opportunity there for doing translation work. And you can do this in many of the different platforms like Upwork, Fiverr. Really, you just need to be able to translate from one language to the other. Of course, if you can use English, that's probably the most popular language you're either translating to or from English. There are a lot of great opportunities there if you have more than one language. Many people take this even further. They actually do education in languages. So they'll do like one-to-one tuition, teaching people Spanish, teaching them French, different languages. And you can even do group meetings. I see this a lot recently. People are doing Zoom meetings. So they get multiple people that want to learn the language together. They all pay a small fee. And ultimately, the teacher can collectively make enough money to make it worth their while. So you sometimes you can do this without needing any certification. So I see a lot of people doing this now and they don't have any certification. But if you're just a beginner and wanting to learn a new language, then I think it's still a good opportunity, even if that person who's taking the class is not a professionally trained teacher. You can still learn a lot just by attending that class. So if you know a second language and are comfortable enough in that language to be able to teach it and do translation work, there are quite a number of opportunities in that area. The last opportunity I will talk about in this video is based around Fiverr. Now, if you've used Fiverr, you will notice that there are a lot of different kinds of jobs out there on Fiverr. So these are different gigs that people will do, and many of these are templated And this is something I see happening a lot now because I've been trying to hire people for different opportunities. You will see a lot of templated jobs. And the real beauty of this is that they do the work once and they sell these templates. Actually just means that once they get a sale, they just take the files that they have created in the past and they will send them to the customer. So this is the kind of work that you can do across multiple gigs on Fiverr and build a small income from that. Hopefully some of these job types that we have discussed in this video has been helpful to you. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like and subscribe to the channel, and I will see you all in the next video.